Remember that round spot we used to do?
When Silversmiths Michael and Maureen Banner design a new teapot or coffee pot, they're not always sure where it's headed. Although up is the likely direction.
You know what I was thinking about? A spout top teapot thing.
Oh, so the spout would be the whole pot?
Well, no, I mean up at near the top. I'm more adventurous design-wise. He's more steady.
I think Maureen brings a creativity, a looseness to a piece. She doesn't worry too much whether or not the piece is going to function.
But when their two approaches come together, no one can argue with the sterling results. To the form, Maureen brings nearly a lifetime of experience in pottery, sculpture, and jewelry. To the function, Michael brings 40 years of experience in jewelry and metalsmithing. They live in the quiet woods of the Berkshires, Massachusetts, still happily working together 33 years after they married in Chicago.
I dropped pottery and took up jewelry, so I learned to make earrings and little things and work so we could be together, because it was more romantic.
More than 20 years ago, they decided to try their hands at their first sterling silver teapot. Their improbable long-stemmed handles started to grow a couple of years later, inspired by a piece of jewelry.
I made these big collars that came around the neck, and one day, maybe a year or so after we made these, we took one apart, and Maureen held the two pieces and held it against the teapot and said, "Handles!"
Today, Maureen is sketching a single handle design. From Maureen's drawing, Michael creates a pattern. He traces and cuts one side of the teapot body from a sheet of heavyweight sterling silver. To give shape to flat silver, Michael starts with a soft steel stake. He uses the stake's curves to create a lip at the top and bottom of the teapot, using a wooden mallet.
If I used a steel hammer and hit it down, it would thin the metal.
Then Michael uses some muscle and a blowhorn stake to push the sheet into the shape of half a teapot. He flattens the edges and files them to ensure a tight fit where the two sides meet. Michael then uses steel wire to bind the two halves into what looks like a teenager's orthodontic nightmare.
If we do not bind this piece very tightly, the silver is going to warp. As I apply heat in one area, it's going to expand, and the other areas aren't going to expand, so it's going to move around.
The silver solder requires high heat, about 850 degrees, and if Michael is not careful, he could burn a hole right through the pot. But as usual, Michael's solders are seamless. He quickly removes the wires and pickles the pot.
I put the body of the teapot in a pickle. It's a very mild acid that I use just to clean the flux off and all the oxide off of the piece.
A few minutes later, the teapot is beginning to look ready for a spot of tea.
I love making teapots. Teapots, to me, offer a huge range of possibilities.
The petite and simple body sets the stage for the willowy handle that will sweep the teapot off its feet. On a cold day in the Berkshires, Maureen and Michael Banner warmly discuss the emerging shape of a sterling teapot.
Spout reminds me sort of a bird beak.
Good.
We got a name already.
The parts constantly change along the way, as Michael coaxes Maureen's charcoal drawing into a silver vessel that will actually pour.
They are sculpture, and a lot of people treat them as sculpture. They don't use them. But I'm really concerned that they do function.
This afternoon, Michael is making one of the banner's sinuous handles, a reflection of their love of nature. He cuts two matching slivers of silver.
The pot we're making is going to be called Lucifer because there's a plant that comes up like this, and comes over, and the flowers all hang from the top.
Then he starts hollowing the handle. He uses a small nylon hammer to push the silver into an indentation in a block of wood. He refines the shape against a curved steel stake. Then he planishes the silver.
What we're trying to do is smooth the metal, even though it looks like it's hammered, but we're getting all the major ups and downs out of the metal and making it perfectly flat.
As he did with the body, he wires the two sides together. But the handle has a more complex shape, so he needs a tighter wrap to keep the silver from shifting as he solders it.
And I put the solder at the top. The gravity would let the solder flow down in the crack, down the seam, all the way to the bottom.
With so much binding wire, it's not unusual for some of it to wind up soldered to the handle. Whatever Michael can't cut, he files away.
His craftsmanship is exacting. His patience is amazing.
I feel that silver should have some whimsy. It should have some movement. It should feel free and really explode out of the pot.
In 3 weeks, Michael transforms Maureen's drawing into a pot with personality, its arm beckoning a unique invitation to tea.
We don't even think about what sells. We just design what we want. And it's fun to be creative and see your piece go from a concept to a full-fledged thing.
The designs of Michael and Maureen Banner send silver drifting upward, like steam rising from a teapot, carrying messages of infinite possibility.